I just want to double check. Y'all's dogs eat pears fresh from the tree, right? It's not just mine. Not just my dog. Well, hey, how doing? How are you, everybody? It's your friendly mutton chop right here. I got my handy dandy hole saw set, and we're going to attempt to go ahead and put some holes in the bottom of these fire barrels. You know, little tiny drill bit, one hole, no good. Water still accumulates. Waiting on our cement here. Yeah, so hey, how you doing? Didn't film any of it, and I really probably should have, because it was probably one of my most comical adventures yet. It was, first of all, I mean, this goes up higher, but the wind's blowing, so I got it low. And I had it only one notch higher than this yesterday, so I kept on clocking my fucking head on it, which was a sight to see, and that was fun. And, you know, I had a bright idea setting this pole and then putting this thing over that pole and on the sawhorses and then sliding these poles in through the holes that I had already made and right into the holes that I already dug. Well, of course, the holes I dug didn't 100% line up. And getting this onto that pole, sliding over, was hilarious. I didn't have anybody to help me. And I've got this thing all framed out, right? So, you know, I've got 2x4s all on this bitch, so it ain't light. And, you know, all around, both sides, all four corners, all four sides, and across the middle, bracing it. I'm still going to do more for actually making a workbench. Oh my goodness, so I was just jacking it up with the different, you know, all different types of series of longer and shorter and longer poles and whatnot, until I got her high enough to balance on the top of that bad boy so that I could, you know, slide it over so I could, you know, balance it on there. And on, I had this one on this corner and that one that's on the ground on, you know, on one of the corners. I had each one of those big-ass 6x6s on each one of these corners. And then I had my hands on this trying to, and, of course, even though I did so carefully and measured everything, my 2x4 still encroached upon my holes for some reason. I think because I know now, because I didn't have my router plunged deep enough. And my jigsaw blade is just a little tiny short one, so the blade definitely wasn't. It just went through the how you doing, a little bit into the 2x4. And my router, I didn't have plunged deep enough, set deep enough. So I end up just banging the fuck out of this rubber mallet, getting it on down there. And then, of course, today when I went to take it off, it was a motherfucker to get it off. So I set that pole. I put these in, rather, these two, this one and this one, to set them. And I couldn't get this one in because it's a 6-foot pole and there wasn't enough clearance. Right? Wasn't enough clearance. This is higher. You know, that's the lower end of the pitch. So I was able to get these two in, set these this morning. I put them in last night, but I set them this morning, and I had quickcrete, so it's only 4 hours, right? They set in 20 minutes, and they can take structural in 4 hours. And I had to dig out this hole more to get it level and square. And then this pole was not there. So then I had to do the same thing, get this bitch up atop of these three poles, the same way I did yesterday with a series of wood, jacking it higher and higher. Of course, this time it was even worse because so I went ahead and loosened the boards, the 2x4, so I could get, oh my goodness, it was a whole production, it was. And then I get it on top of these three, and then I balance it with another wedge under this one, and then I chisel out that 2x4 there, which I'd already done on these other three corners, so that it would then slide easily. And then, of course, I didn't double check this one and see that it was chiseled out, so I've got a bunch of, you know, mar on there. There's another piece of wood that's going over the top of this, so it's not a big deal, but, you know, I ate into my 2x4, my 4x4 and everything, because I was, you know, whatever. But anyway, so, needless to say, I had to dig this hole out more, too. But I got that, I got this all the way lifted up, I got my pole set up underneath, I got my damn sheet back on top of our four, or over all four poles. Got this one squared up after, you know, chiseling the fuck out of it and lifting it up so I could actually get the pole out of there, so I could dig out that hole more that way, so I could kick the bottom out that way, so I could get the whole damn thing perfectly perpendicular. And yeah, is that the right word, perpendicular? And I got it braced, and I got half quickcrete, and I ran out of bag, and I got the rest just high professional grade. And that's a little lower, right? A little lower. But hey, how you doing? You know, not that bad. And I'll just put some gravel on the top of it, and no big whoop. And of course, this is not set or level or anything. I'll pop this back off tomorrow when these are all dry, when I can get somebody to help. I'm not doing it by myself again. Twice is enough. And, oh, how you doing? I never even saw you. You just been hanging out there all day? Just, I've been working here all day, nonstop, and you just been chilling right beside me. How you doing? Buddy? I feel I destroyed about half your fucking web. I feel like your web might have been a little bit bigger than that. I put on my big grill gloves, and I scooped it into a plastic cup, and I let it out way over yonder. Way over yonder. But look, I still signed it. I still signed it. Yeah, why would you focus, Sony? You're only a fucking camera. I just want to double check. Y'all's dogs eat pears fresh from the tree, right? It's not just mine. Not just my dog. Oh my goodness. He loves some groceries and stuff. You must want some more. It's not totally sweet, it's slightly sour. But it's just about good. But he's always the one that eats all these pears. They didn't grow last year. Because, apparently you need the Bradford pear, the big ones, you know, the one that fell in my yard. You need that to pollinate the one that fruits, which is this one, which is a little skinny one. Yeah, that's the big one, like the one that fell, right? And that's the one that fruits. These are all Bradford pears too, along the fence line. And let that one grow. And let that one on the very end grow. And cut all that. And then cut that little bit of on the side of that one. That's the Bradford pear, but cut that garbage. So I've been clearing all this shit off. I've been clearing out my back deck. That was a few weeks ago, or a week ago or so. It's a bunch of poison ivy and shit, so I've just been letting that die out. Honestly, I may wait till I buy a little fucking tractor for do any of that. But yeah, we want Bradford pear there. We want Bradford pear. We want some shade, right? So we're trying to promote some growth for Fark Socks. We are. But yeah, man, I cannot believe these little fucking John Deere's, Makitas, all of them, the little tiny fucking tiniest little fucking tractors with the bucket and the deck, lawn mowing deck and all that shit. Goddamn, $20,000, man. Best case scenario, $21,000. Like, used, like $16,000. Gotta stop talking when I'm moving the tripod, because I'm just killing the audio quality. My videos are already shitty enough, so I gotta get in the habit of that. Y'all remind me in the comments. Hey, fuckface, why don't you shut the fuck up and finish moving the tripod, and then just cut all that shit out, and then just edit the part where you're talking and filming good, fucker. But so yeah, just waiting on that to dry. Probably good enough, but I got other shit to do, so we'll just let her keep on keeping on until we're ready to Freddy. Just check the old, I mean, she's pretty good. She ain't square. Oh, son of a dick. You know, I forgot I got my old how you doing lowered here, and it's just a head knocker. She is a bit of a head knocker. We'll let you check out level, we will. Or, you know, my version of it. So, you know, not too bad. Pretty close, you know, a little bit off, but get this hole saw thing put together and we'll go drill some holes, we will. Probably. That's pretty cool how these work. In case you're unaware, I'll shunt you. I'm an idiot. See, I'm an idiot. It's true. Watch your teeth. They'll cut you, they will. So you just, this is called your mandrel. This right here, this whole thing is called your mandrel. And see, this bad boy's got those four holes in it. And you got some threads on the end of your mandrel here. And this shaft slides up and down, and this shaft has got two lock and hole nubs in it that fit in these here holes. So you thread your mandrel onto your hole bit, and then you get the closest, as tight as you can, to line it up with the nubbins, and you slide the nubbins in there. And I was trying to turn it with the nubbins stuck in there instead of just pulling it back, which is why I'm an idiot. And you tighten down this other. How you doing? Well, let me show you how it works. It's my first time ever using it, and I've never actually used it because I just tried it on my kitchen counter and I completely fucked up. How you doing? And you probably get a wrench and get real high, throw it a little bit. And then you lock that bitch in. Oh. Okay, I can only use the smaller bits. That's how that works. Yeah, that's how that works, is you can only use the smaller bits, which aren't near as substantial. Obviously, in the mandrel is much smaller, and it doesn't have any of the triple locking. How you doing? Of course, these are from metal, right? And I mean, I'm drilling through metal, but this is made for, like, you know, presumably like some sort of, you know, giant drill press or something. At the very least, maybe one of those big old handheld double how you doings drills. But we're gonna try this little bitty and see how she works. We are. Okay, we got a barrel here and we got our how you doing, and I'm gonna assume that's a metal bit since it's coming in a bimetal hole saw kit. And we're gonna get to doing it. We're gonna get to getting it. We are. Well, that was easy. Probably should have some hearing protection. Of course, I used the hole already there to guide my bit. Let's try one without. That was just as easy. Oh my goodness. Hole saw 2, old rusty barrel 0. Oh my goodness, you want to see her up close? We'll give you a double how you doing.
Not a double how you doing.
Yes, a double, how you doing? That's a pre-existing hole, right? So we just stick the drill bit in there and give her the old whack. So I'm not giving her hardly, but a touch of downward pressure. That one seems a little bit rougher, though, than the others. Okay, and we'll shunt you a freshie. Not a freshie chop, yeah, freshie chop. Freshie chop, freshie chop. Fresh, fresh, freshy job. Make sure y'all are. Oh yeah, I've got some freshy chop. Okay, that was with a little bit more substantial down pressure. As you may be able to tell, there was very little wandering. It's a pretty clean hole as opposed to this one. It's got all the. See how it's got all the shavings? Hold on. Tell from a cyber glance, but you see from down on, see it's got all the wanderings here. Same with the very first one I did. Second one, clean. Fourth one, clean. Go ahead and haul that one out in the middle and we'll be done. Is how you lift something that's way too heavy and way too big for you. It is. That's how you do that. Okay, well apparently workbenches are supposed to be approximately like 36 inches off the ground. I think I said this in yesterday's video, but I'm a little bit taller. I think I said everything I was gonna do, so I'm not gonna say a bunch of shit right now. I got it at like 39. You know, my ground's uneven. I can always move it up. What the fuck, I can't move it up. What am I thinking? Stop saying that, chop. Fuck. So yeah, I better make sure it's actually as high as I fucking want it. regard even or as low as I wanted if I put more ground in, if I put more earth in. Yeah, okay. Well, I got it at 39 now. We're going to see if that's where it stays or not. Okay, dead on 39 ought to be good. I can always lower it, but I can't raise it. So if I put some ground in, then that'll be fine. Yeah, it still gives me 3 inches of play. And if I don't, I can always, and if the sun comes on my back, I can always lower it. And I'm just going to trust the level because, goddamn, from an eye standpoint, that does not look level at all. But it's also because I'm looking at all sorts of other stuff behind it and on the ground and the slanted other stuff. And the, but the level says it's level, so we're going to trust it. Oh my goodness! Look at all the pikujas! Supposedly, I can use this to stream stuff from my phone to my TV without actually having to physically plug my phone into the TV, which is the type of setup I have now. Then every time I gotta pause it and all that shit is so, hey, how you doing? And I got volume 2, because I didn't have volume 2, only got volume 1. And I got the Mission Impossible series, because the whole damn thing was only $39, so how you doing? How you doing? $39, all the films, go. Okay, and I'm just working on this. I got one cross brace in here. I got it. For some reason, I'm hand sawing everything. But yeah, my skill saw right now, it's got the, you know, it's got that Craig thing on it, and it's all, so I'm just like fucking. But this hand saw is not designed for sawing wood like this. So I'm having a hell of a time at it, but I think I'm about done for today. I think I'm just about done for today. So I got into, showed you all those bushes I was cleaning up, or I think I did, but you know, they had thorns all in them, and like everywhere a thorn touched me, I got a little infected. I mean, I got like fucking 30 of these little bumps all over my hands, just hurting like a son of a gun. They've subsided. They're not as worse. They're not as bad as this morning, but hell, I was half convinced I had scabies or something. I mean, look at the size of that. Actually, that one might be a blood blister from yesterday. But I don't think so. I think it's one of those things, because they're just, they're everywhere. That's the big video. So I apologize. Punch up out.